Okay, our new unit of work is on trigonometry. Trigonometry deals with right angle triangles. So earlier in the year we looked at Pythagoras' theorem, where we said for Pythagoras' theorem, c squared equals a squared plus b squared, and that works for any three sides in a right angle triangle. Trigonometry, we're dealing with right angle triangles, but we're dealing with two sides and one angle. So we might get given two sides and have to calculate the given angle, or we might get given an angle and one of the sides and have to calculate the other side. So the first thing that we need to do when we're talking about, when we're dealing with trigonometry, is to be able to label our sides. So if I draw a right angle triangle, it looks like that. Now we always know from our work with Pythagoras' theorem that this longer side is called the hypotenuse. And that's always opposite the right angle. So it's the longest side in the right angle triangle opposite the right angle. When we're dealing with trigonometry, we'll have an angle given to us. So it might be this angle, or it might be the other angle. Doesn't matter which one. But when we do that, we have to label these other two sides, and we label these two sides relative to this angle. So this side that is opposite the angle is called the opposite side. And this side that is next to this angle, another word for being next to something is to say that it's adjacent to it. So we have three sides, the hypotenuse, the opposite and the adjacent, and our first step in trigonometry is to being able to label those. Sometimes we just label those as H for hypotenuse, A for adjacent, and O for opposite. Okay. Now, it gets a little bit harder than that because our right angle triangle can be orientated in different directions and might have sort of different shapes about it. So I'll put up a few different examples. Let's do this. And let's say our angle here is this one. Let's do another one. Let's say our angle of interest is there. A couple more. And one last one. Okay, for these four triangles, I'm going to label the three sides in all of those. So, for this first triangle, this is my angle. This is my opposite side. It's directly opposite the angle. My longest side is opposite the right angle, so that's going to be my hypotenuse. And the side next to the angle is the adjacent side. Okay. With this next triangle, my longest side, even though it switched around a bit, will be this side. So longest side in this triangle, it's opposite the right angle. This side here is next to the angle. So this will be my adjacent side. And lastly, this side is opposite that angle. Opposite, adjacent, hypotenuse. Here, my longest side is now on this side. Down here, opposite the right angle. The side opposite the angle is here, and my adjacent side will be here. And lastly, my long side for this one is here, so that's my hypotenuse. This is my angle that I'm interested in, so this is the side that's opposite the angle, this is the side that's adjacent to the angle. So our first step in trigonometry is to be able to label our sides.